Hello friend, hope you have enjoyed the course and learned a lot about XPath and SelectTrace writing. So let us take our first locator challenge. Which one is not the correct format of XPath? So I'm sure like you all have learned about the format and the syntax of XPath. So let's see which is not the correct format of XPath. We have to find out which one is the wrong format. So the very first one, if you see that, this is how we used to write the XPath double forward slash tag name at the rate attribute name is equal to attribute value, and then it is written as following sibling colon colon tag name. Okay, so looks like here it is, forward slash is missing, right? If you remember, recall that we used to write the forward slash after this close square bracket. Let's see the second one. Tag name at the rate attribute name is equal to attribute value. Again, looks like forward slash is missing after closing bracket. Forward slash is not there, directly they have written the tag name. Then the third one, double forward slash tag name at the rate attribute value, attribute name is equal to value following sibling. So again, here that forward slash is missing. Just to cross verify, let us copy these values here.
let me just verify these values.
Let me show you this same thing if this is wrong or right here in selector sub. So just right click on inspect. And here if we write this double forward slash, let's say we write an XPath, and here if we write the following FO, what was this following sibling tag name, right? FO, following sibling and then tag name, it was written like this. So we got the message that after close and forward slash only open square it is allowed. So this is wrong here. Either we'll have to write an open square bracket or the forward slash. So this is wrong syntax. Similar goes for the second one. If we would have written the, like here after close the square bracket, if we would have written the tag name, then also this error comes. And if you verify this thing here in Chrome DevTools, you will not see that error. You will feel it will show 0 of 0 matching node, which you might think like, okay, this is not no matching node, but you didn't get the error. Actually, there is an error. So this is these two are the wrong syntax, and the same goes for this again, right? So this is wrong syntax. So the answer is D, all of the above. So these are the wrong syntax. All are the wrong syntax here. The next question, write an XPath to get all the block titles on this page. Okay, so on this blog.testproject.io, here we have to get the block titles. Okay, so let's see here, blog.testproject.io, here we have to get these block titles, all the block titles here. Okay, so don't worry, like when you will be at the time when you will be looking for this page, there could be different name, but the XPath will be same. You just have to focus on like the logic. No need to worry about that. Similar XPath for one element could be written in multiple ways. Okay, so we have to write an XPath to get the titles of the blocks here. Okay, so you can see that here, if we verify this, we verified this is the first title here. So this comes with H3 and class is sticky post title. Same if we verify, if we inspect this, that one is A here and H3 post title. Okay, so we have to get all these post title like this, these one. So how we will write the XPath for these? This one is this here, double forward slash H3, and we need the A here. So you see that we got all 7 here, 7 titles on this page here.
So we are getting all of them. Now, as we there are two ways. One is that this we can use in our Selenium script, and we can use the XPath method. Sorry, we can use the getText method to get the name of these. And I won't suggest this XPath as of now, because this is not that robust XPath. Just that, like, having double forward slash H3 and forward slash A doesn't make that robust XPath. So we will have to make it more robust, so that it it won't get changed immediately, right? So for that, you can either mention here this @ class. But you see that when you mention this @ class post title, we didn't get this one, we get only these one. So these are the post titles, and this is the basically like the top one, header one. If you inspect this, you will get it. H3 sticky post title. So if we have to get this one as well, and all these, so basically our question was get all the block titles. So we have to get all of them, not just this one, not just these one. We need to get these and these as well. So what we will do, in place of equal, we will use contains class. Contains @ class here, and class we can take the, and did you notice here when I was typing here like this, because double forward slash H3 was there, and when I was typing this one contains, so you notice that we didn't get the while typing, we didn't get the auto suggest region, because we here there is no attribute like that for which it can suggest, and we are writing XPath for H3, so we will have to inspect this element here. So keep that in mind. So now if you will start typing here, you will get that as well. So we want the class with post title, so take this post title. Now we get all seven, and we need the A here, so all the names link we got, and we are getting the text. So this you can use it in your script, Selenium script, or whichever automation API framework is you are using, so in that you can use. Now if you want the text through XPath itself, in that case you can just forward slash text. There's a method, there's a function in XPath, you can just add that forward slash text. You see that you are getting the text value using XPath itself. So you see that this is the name of your first blog, the best of the best in 2020 community year in review. So you see that the second one goes here, you see the role of. So this is how we get the text as well. If you just want XPath, which you can use it in your automation script, you can use this. If you want the text direct from XPath, you can write like this. And this is basically many a times people use it like in web scraping and many other stuff. So yeah, that way you can use, and directly you can get the values here. Okay, and don't worry, like, you don't think that okay, this is the XPath, right XPath, this is right XPath which we have written. You might have written like you could have written something different as well. So same for one element element, we can write n number of XPath, so you need not to worry about that. It should be finding the right element, as well as it should be the robust one, that you have to always consider. For same element, we can write n number of XPath. Now write an XPath to get all the patron monthly names which are not the links. This is really good example, good challenge. This is good question. So here basically we, on this page, sponsors page of selector serve, we have to find out all the monthly patron which are not the link. Basically this, all these are link, if you see that. So these are not the link, so we have to find out, write an XPath to get all the patron monthly names which are not the link. Let's see how can we write XPath for these element. So first we have to write the XPath for these elements, right? We have to find out all the monthly pattern. So with respect to this, we have to write XPath for them, right? So first we will have to write XPath for this, then we will find out the common parent for both, and then we will write the XPath for these element, right? This is the fundamental concept. Now let's inspect and open selector sum. First we need to write the XPath for month patro monthly, right? Because with respect to this we have to find out the names. So here we can write simply, so we have written the patro monthly XPath. Now we have to find out the parent, I mean common parent for both all the li's, and this div is the common, this div is the common parent for all the li, right? So we can just like go to parent and this is parent div. So we got the parent div. Now we want all the li under this, right? So here either you inspect any element here, let's say we inspect this one, so this li and then a is there, but we don't need a, right? We just need li first. So double forward slash li. Now we got all the element, but we have to find out only those which are not the link, right? This. So if you notice here, this li which are having the link, the text is going inside link. And if we inspect this element which is not having the link, you see that li is having the direct text. So whenever there is an element which has the text, whenever there is a tag which has the text, that we can directly figure it out, directly fetch by using text method in that, like this. And now if you press enter, you will see that only those li it is giving which is having the text, because other elements are having text inside a tag, in the child tag, that's why they are not getting with this. So this is really useful in that case when we have to find out those tags which are having the text. Okay, so this is the XPath for these three elements. Remember, this function is really important. Next question: which one is the correct format of XPath? We have to figure it out which one is the correct format. Let's see. Double forward slash tag name attribute name is equal to attribute value. Okay, so looks like correct, but let's if we copy this one, you see that equal is equal to double quote here and single quote. So this is not right format. Okay, tag name at the rate attribute name is equal to attribute value tag name, again forward slash is missing here, so this is again wrong. Tag name at the rate attribute name is equal to attribute value forward slash following dash sibling colon colon tag name. This looks correct. Let's see the last one. Tag name, so this goes here itself, double forward slash is not there, so this is not the XPath. This is wrong format, this is wrong format. C is the right answer. And if you want to verify, you can write them in selector sub and you can verify them, you will get that like this. If you want me to show here, so anyone we will pick like this, let's say double quote and single quote. So here if you write like this, let's say this one double forward slash a, and here, so what is there in at value, here is double quote, there is a single quote, so it will let you know that single quote is missing or double quote is missing, so that way you can verify that. Which is the wrong format for SVG element? So let's first see what is the right format of SVG element. So I hope you guys remember that what is the right format of SVG syntax, what is the syntax for SVG. So if you have to write an XPath for SVG element, this is for the child and this is SVG here. So this is the right syntax, double forward slash star local name is equal to SVG. Now see what are the options here, double forward slash li dash icon at the rate type image this. So it is asking which is the wrong format. So double forward slash star local dash name is equal to SVG. This looks correct. This is a CSS selector. So ID, hashtag ID, arrow, tag name, arrow, tag name. This is also, this is a correct CSS selector format. This is wrong. Double forward slash star, this is right. Till here it is right. Forward slash SVG, this is wrong. Because for SVG, we cannot, forward slash SVG is the wrong syntax. Let us see here, if we would have written double forward slash SVG, what it says. Invalid SVG XPath format. So this is wrong. So the answer, which is the wrong format for SVG element? This is the wrong format. Next, which locator can work for shadow DOM elements? I hope you all remember that we have learned XPath doesn't support shadow DOM. So which all are XPath here? This is XPath, so this will not work. This is again XPath, this is again XPath. So these three will not work. The B second option will work because that is a CSS selector. We will learn about more about CSS selector very soon. I will be uploading a complete series on CSS selector so that you can learn. And yes, another question is, write an XPath to get all the social media link present at the footer of this page in the bottom. Okay, so on this testproject.io, go here, we have to figure it out. All the write an XPath to get all the social media link present at the footer of this page. So if we inspect this element, so basically these are all the social footer link here. Okay, so we got this element UL. Under this UL there are a tags which are having the social media link. So how can we write the XPath for them? So here we can write double forward slash UL. This is the parent. We need all the anchor tag here, double forward slash a here. So we get all the six link. Now again, as we know that we can write the XPath with the help of attribute as well. So if you want to get the attribute through your automation script, Selenium script, you can use this XPath and get the attribute href that will give all the links. Or you can do directly here at the rate href and press enter. Here you see selector sub will give you all the six link here itself. So you can directly get all the links this way. So this is another formula you learned, that you can write, get the attribute value through XPath as well. You just, like if you want the class, you can use at the rate class. You want href, you can directly use href, like I showed you guys that text over there in that another example. So this is how you can get the href, all the links as well. There could be a different formula as well to write the same XPath for the same elements. So yeah. Hope this lecture was really helpful for you guys, this locator challenge. There are more locator challenge. I will be uploading as a complete locator series, locator challenge series, another course, so that soon you will get it. I would really request you, if this course, I mean all the this course is absolutely free, so if you find it useful, you can donate and support for this project. Here you can get the PayPal and my Google Pay number here. Also you can donate here by clicking on the selector sub, and you can support selector sub. This is an absolutely free product for everyone. Don't forget to add the review for this course. Please support, please share this course with everyone, and let everyone know this course. This is going to definitely help them a lot to learn about the XPath and other selectors in real time. Even if they are a beginner or expert, they will definitely learn something new. Hope you learned something new today. And if you have any question, any query, feel free to reach out to me here at the selector sub. You will get all the footer, all the like link over here. You can connect and reach out to me. That, thank you so much. There will be another locator challenge, that will be a different course, so you can check it out later. Thank you.